She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting up like last week. Tell me, where have you been? You came out of hiding, girl. Don't act like I'm your man. You're just a fan. You don't hold rain.
SimplySaree, and I'm back at it again with another video. So just a couple quick tidbits before we get into this video. I just wanted to say a few things. First off, I apologize for the hiatus. It was summertime, it was a lot going on. Towards the end of the year, it always gets crazy when it comes to the finals and things like that. So I was really focused on my studies, which I know that y'all will understand. I'm a college student, and even though there's a lot of fun and games on here, it's also very serious. So I always take my academics very serious. So was dealing with finals and stuff like that. Summer came around, I had a full-time job, so I was working, making that coin, vacations. I had a lot of stuff going on. Also, I was taking 2 summer courses just to boost my credit. So I'm so sorry for the hiatus, but I am back and I'm better. You can't see everything behind me, but as you can probably tell, I'm all moved into my new apartment. I'm gonna give you guys a room tour, but before I get to that, it is Sunday. Today was the end of move-in week for the most part. People call it move-in day. I like to call it move-in week because people move in at different times throughout the week. Not everybody comes on one day, even if they're supposed to. I know it started on Monday, and typically Sunday is when the last bit of people come in to move in their things. So move-in week is done, and freshmen had their first, you know, welcome week and had all of their activities and everything. So the school year officially gets started tomorrow on the dots, early in the morning, Monday morning. Everybody is going to class. So I just got a new job working at the DSU bookstore, so you can catch me in there Tuesdays and Thursdays, sometimes a Saturday. I work probably most of the time in the morning times, like the afternoon, if you guys ever want to see me. But I got a new job at the bookstore. I just started working there, and freshmen have been coming in and out trying to get all their things together, and so many of y'all have approached me and been like, oh my gosh, I watch your YouTube channel, and oh my, and I'm subscribed, and I love your content. And I just want to say thank you guys so much. I'm glad that I can help you. I'm glad that you guys are all settled in, and I wish you guys a successful year. Do not hesitate to contact me. Do not hesitate to follow me on any of my social media, and do not hesitate to say hi if you see me on campus. I am mad nice. I am always really friendly, and I will talk to any of y'all. Y'all could literally just pull up beside me and be like, so girl, let me tell you about my day. And I'm gonna be like, what happened? I am mad cool. Y'all can talk to me anytime y'all want. Do not be shy. Like, I really want to meet all of you. I want to talk with you guys. I want to help be a guidance for you guys, or be a guide for you guys. I want to help you guys get adjusted to campus life and everything. And I just want to be your friend. So if you guys are around campus and you see me, just be like, yo, what's up? And I'm be like, what's happening? And we can, you know, hit it off. So I want to say thank you guys so much for the support, so much for the love. I really, really appreciate it. Y'all, all of my babies, I love you guys so much. Now let's get into today's video. So today I'm going to be doing a quick little apartment tour. This video is not going to be very long. It's not going to be too in-depth, because even I don't know every single thing about my building. I literally just moved in maybe 3 days ago. So when I did my move-in video for freshman year Jenkins, I was there. I had been there already a couple months, so I was already acclimated to my surroundings, and I knew where everything was, and I knew what everything did. I'm in a totally different building on the other side of campus now, the Village Apartments, so I'm still learning every day about the little things that we got in our building. But I just wanted to give you guys a general introduction. I just wanted to give you guys a little piece of what I got going on, so you guys can see what I'm working with, see my new living situation. I also wanted to give the freshmen a visual of what they would be coming into if, when you are done your freshman year, you want to apply to the Village Apartments. This is one of the options you can have. I live in a 2-bedroom suite. It is an apartment, so let me just say, it's a 2-bedroom apartment. The reason why it's called a suite is because we don't have a full kitchen. Like, that's the one downside about having a suite. You only get a mini fridge and a microwave. So you do not have a full stove and all of that to, like, you know, chef it up anywhere. Like, you really are only subject to your microwave and your mini fridge. But other than that, it is a two-bedroom apartment. We have one bathroom. It's really, really nice. It's my first time ever being in the Ville, period. I've never been over here really like that other than to eat at the cafe. I just want to give you guys a quick little tour about my new living situation and everything. So without further ado, let's get started.
University Village is an on-campus student housing neighborhood located on 25 acres on the campus of Delaware State University. Featuring four-story residential buildings, it is comprised of four buildings containing 300 units, 628 beds, and a 250-seat dining hall facility. Designated primarily for upperclassmen students, it features luxury apartments in a one-bedroom, one-bathroom, two-bedroom, two-bathroom, and a four-bedroom, two-bathroom configurations ranging from 450 square feet to 1,241 square feet. Each apartment is fully furnished with extra-long twin beds, full-size kitchens, and convenient dining and living areas. Each suite-style unit offers many of the same amenities with kitchenette in lieu of a full kitchen. So right now I'm taking you guys to the front of my building. I live in building 3. Typically, just like last year, you're gonna need your ID to get into your building, but because it's move-in week, they just left the door open for everybody. This is the front lobby. This is where the front office is, where you can sign visitors in and out and things like that. And this is our hallway. And to the right, one of the first buildings you're gonna come into, or the first rooms you're gonna come into, is the laundry room. It comes with 3 washers and 3 dryers, and it has the same type of setup in Jenkins. You just swipe your card if you have a laundry voucher. Not sure how many units there are to each hallway, but this is what it looks like walking down the hall. When you come to the left side of the building, you're gonna see the office, and that office with the little orange paper on it is typically where the RAs or the RA on call or the assignment coordinator, like all of them usually are in that office. And now, welcome to my apartment. So as you guys can see, the first thing you need to do in order to get into your room is to use a swipe card, not your ID. It is a swipe card. They program it for you when you move in. You just slide it down the little silver kiosk thing and it should light green and let you into your building. And you need to keep that and your ID on you for entrance purposes. Now, immediately to your left of my apartment, you're gonna see our kitchenette area. The kitchenette, like I said in the beginning, includes a microwave and a fridge. It also comes with a sink so you can wash any dishes that you may bring with you. Then when you pivot to your right, you're gonna see our living room. Now, just to give you a quick little panel, this is what the living room looks like. It comes with like a little shelf where you can put a television in the living room if you want. I keep mine in my room. I'm not sure if my roommate has her own, but that's all up to you. If you want to bring a TV and put it in the living room, definitely discuss that with your roommate. But that's what that little space is for. It does come with 2 sofas, a nice little coffee table, and a nice little table next to the other chair. It's a cute little setup. While the apartments do come semi-furnished, all the little decorations and things like that in the room were personally brought by either myself or my roommate. The next door you're gonna come across, when you open that, that leads to, I don't even know what's called, it's not really the bathroom, but it's like our little segue into where the rooms are, and then straight ahead is the bathroom. Immediately to your right is where our sinks are. So the sinks are not in the bathroom, they are outside the bathroom. My sink is to the right, and where you see the spray on the left, that is where my roommate's side is. So they give us a full mirror so you can come out, do your hair, do your makeup, wash your face, brush your teeth, whatever you gotta do in the full mirror. mirror, and they give us two separate sinks for that. They also, below them, have cabinets where you could store any of your supplies, any of your beauty products, anything that you'd like to put under the sink for extra storage. So the bathroom just consists of, you know, typical bathroom stuff, but the sinks are outside. Also, when we came in, we also had this long chair. I believe every room has one, I'm not sure, but ours did, and I like to use it for when I'm doing my makeup. And then on our wall, my roommate brought like pretty little sticker decals just to fill in the empty space. Now when you walk straight back and make a right, you're gonna come to two doors. Now the one to the right, I don't know what's in there. It will not open. I'm not sure if you need a certain key. I don't know, maybe that's my side and I don't have my key yet. So that's probably why it doesn't open. But the left side, my roommate stored her storage, some of her things in this little storage closet. So for right now we share the racks on there, but you can put all of your bathroom cleaner supplies, living room cleaning supplies, and just that general area space cleaning supplies in this little cabinet area, or you could put really whatever you want in there. It's really up to you. Straight back is our bathroom. Like I said, we have a two bedroom, one bathroom apartment. So we share a bathroom, but it's pretty standard. We have a shower rack, like a little towel rack to the side where the toilet is. We also have just a standard shower. I didn't pull the curtains back so you guys could see what the shower looked like. Not for any reason, it's just the shower curtain is mad cute. So I just decided to leave it how it is. But it is like a step-in shower, so you technically could take a bath, but that's gross, so don't do that. And there's a toilet and a couple racks that we have, and yeah, that's our bathroom. Now, this should be pretty obvious, but some people have already asked me what's the difference. So, apartment style housing, you have your own room. You do not need to share a space. So, this is my room, room A. I'm just going to open it up and show you guys what I got going on in mi casa. This is my room. Ew. Now your bed size can vary, but most of the people on campus who live on campus have a twin XL size bed. Some people in the village have a full, but that's rare. Most of us have a twin XL. And a lot of y'all have been asking where I got my tapestries from. The left blue zodiac one, I got that from Five Below. And this big one, I got from Amazon. This is just a quick peek of how much storage can fit under the bed, which is pretty good. I have like a trunk. I have two trunks under here. You can't see the pink one. It's way in the back. Two little chests and everything. So it's a lot of storage space under the bed. Now this is just a little desk that is right next to my bed. RIP to my Build-A-Bear on the floor. I don't know how she got over there. Her name is Cuddles. But anyway, so this is my little chest that is right next to my bed. I keep my lava lamp and my fan on there. I just keep like my little medicine and like water and like supplements in there. I don't know why my laundry pods are in there, but that's a different story. So this is basically just where I put little things on the side of my bed. Over there is where I keep my TV. It's not plugged in right now because I don't have my cords. My chest, it comes with four drawer compartments. My little laundry basket is over there. That side is kind of a mess, but you get the gist. I'm gonna show you guys my closet. Now excuse the mess, it looks crazy because not all of my things are hung up. I have a lot of shoes, so not all of them are hung up on the rack, and I still have a couple boxes that are unpacked and a suitcase full of stuff. But this is the closet. I love it so much. It's way better than the one in Jenkins. It's like a walk-in closet a little bit. It's real cute. And last but not least, this little area is behind my door. I switched the setup of my room when I came in. This is my little desk area, and this is pretty self-explanatory. I'ma just do my homework and studies here and cry in my notebooks when life gets hard. And that concludes my apartment tour. I'm so sorry that I couldn't get into heavy detail about everything because I'm still learning the ins and outs of my building, my room, etc. But stay tuned for more content. Please don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, share. I will be coming out with new content soon. Let's have a great school year, y'all. Follow me on all my social media. And until next time, bye-bye.